Today we know that global growth is driven by China and India. With that large growing middle class, a market that every manufacturer in the world is seeking to enter and exploit. So we are only 20 kilometers south of that. Then to the south of Sri Lanka. From the south of Sri Lanka to the South Pole, there is no landmass. According to the United Nations, the law of the sea, Sri Lanka has 10 times more space than the landmass. So if you do a, not a land map, but a sea map of the world, Sri Lanka will look much bigger than it looks now on the land map. So we have this great advantage. I think you will be surprised to know that absolutely two-thirds of the world's maritime traffic, sea traffic, goes by the coast of Sri Lanka. Absolutely two-thirds. It will be difficult for people to believe that when you think of transatlantic traffic, trans-Pacific traffic and all that. But if you look at the oil consignments that go daily from the Middle East, then you will agree with me that the statistics that I quote of two-thirds of the world's maritime traffic going within the coastline of Sri Lanka is absolutely true. Now, given that situation, how do we create an economic growth strategy? One of those prongs of our development strategy is to create two smart cities. One city will be created in Colombo, and the other will be in the southernmost point, which is called Hambantota. Now, here comes another surprise. We have just signed an agreement with a major Chinese company, which will create a new 380 hectares of land from the sea, abutting the city of Colombo. So what you know today as the city of Colombo, in another 5 years will be only half of what will be known as the megapolis of Colombo. Then in the south, I will come to that later, in the south we are developing a new port, which has been assisted by the Exim Bank of China, where we are developing that, for there will be shipbuilding, there will also be oil refining and providing oil to ships which now have to fuel themselves in the Middle East till they reach Singapore. But we are really much closer, and refueling through Colombo, through Hambantota, will be much easier. Now, for that we have built a new harbour, a mini airport and a new city. Now if you take the megapolis, proposed megapolis of Colombo, we have to remember that between Singapore and Dubai, there is not a single place where people can meet, can eat like this, people can discuss financial matters and have a financial hub. So we are trying to position the megapolis of Colombo as a financial and strategic hub between Dubai and Singapore. Now this means we have to create an entirely new city. What are the advantages of a new city? The first is that we have invested very much during the last 10 years in providing infrastructure support. Being a small country, it is comparatively easy to invest in roads, on rapid transport, on electricity, water, all those elements that keeps a big city functioning and alive. So in this new smart city that we are hoping to create, and which already, if you come to Colombo, you will see that the new island in the sea, reclaimed entirely from the sea, is already being built. We have got very good terms. There are 380 hectares which will be reclaimed from the sea. It will not cost the government anything for 350 hectares. 30 hectares will be given to the Chinese company that is doing that development. As you know, China is very good at creating new islands. And you know that there is a new island being now created in the South China Sea.
Yes.
But in Sri Lanka we have no problems, because from the south of Sri Lanka there are no islands except what we are going to create in Colombo. So one is to establish it as a financial center, because of the growing middle class in India, the growing middle class in China, the growing middle class in the rest of Asia needs a financial hub. And I must say at this juncture that the Asian Development Bank has been a partner in the development of this city. We have a what is called a PPP, joint venture, partly funded by the government of Sri Lanka through funding from the Asian Development Bank, where we have built a new breakwater, and the rest of the developments will be done by the private sector. So there is a lot of opportunity in Colombo for investment. It will be in the next decade a major investment center in South Asia as we plan it. We have to have buildings, we have to have banks, we have to have global management, including, I hope, KPMG, and we want to make the new, it is called the new megapolis of Colombo, a vibrant center in South Asia. So we need your assistance. Then when we come to the south of Sri Lanka, where we have a new harbour and a new airport and a host of new hotels like Shangri-La and very soon Four Seasons, then it is very important that we develop that as a vibrant seaport. Already we have Chinese companies and Japanese companies which are negotiating to set up shipbuilding in that port. There's a Japanese company which is trying to build cranes, highly sophisticated cranes for selling to the rest of the world. Boeing is interested in having a center there for repair of their servicing of their planes. So it will be a very vibrant center, because as we learned from China, from Shenzhen, you cannot think of export development growth unless you develop a top-class harbour and a harbour city. So we have set apart 1,000 acres for investment around the harbour of Hambantota. Already 100 Chinese companies have signed up to establish their plants in Hambantota. Only 3 weeks ago, the Prime Minister of Sri Lanka and I, we visited China, we had meetings with the President and Prime Minister of that great country, and they have assured us that they will work very closely with us in developing these two hubs, the hub of metropolitan Colombo and the hub of Hambantota. So these are some of the ideas that we have. We are very open to investment. And as you know, the leap from theory, which India has followed, that is in the modern world, it is always better to start late. Because when you start late, you don't have to go through the errors that your predecessors have gone through. We don't have to go through the problems of the Industrial Revolution. We can immediately go into the post-Industrial Revolution. And the representative body here has that knowledge that they can transfer to Sri Lanka. It should be of mutual benefit. We are going to have very open investment policies. We have enacted what is called the strategic investment law, where with mega investors we can negotiate the terms and conditions. So Sri Lanka, as we envisage it in the next few years, together with agencies like the ADB and hopefully KPGM, we will be able to develop Sri Lanka as a very important financial and a trading hub in South Asia, which is a vacant slot as of today.